mini dorm that cut price Costa Blanca paradise for cost conscious Brits.
€1 for a pint of beer, which is like 84p. You can't get that anywhere, not even Wetherspoons.
Benidorm is a one-off. Don't get anybody to tell you any different. Benidorm is a one-off.
Thousands have made this their permanent home.
Yes, I think I'm here for life. Take me home in a wooden box.
But retirees and the richer side, most expats need to graft to earn their place in the sun.
A lot of people think they can come over here and live the dream, but they don't realise it's all work.
I do 15 hours a day, minimum.
You know, you have to go out and look for work. It may make me €10, but €10 at the end of the day, that's food on the table.
I work hard. I work hard and I play hard.
Meet the bargain-loving Brits in the sun. Coming up, Charity Day frustrations for a Benidorm business owner.
I suspect somebody has complained because we're having fun.
A dad flies out to lay down the law.
That's it, he's grounded from drinking now.
An ambitious new venture for a restaurant owner.
An Indian opening an Italian restaurant. Taking a lot of balls.
And a pensioner takes the plunge. Benidorm gets 300 days of sunshine a year, and today isn't one of them. Torrential rain is threatening to flood the town's famous indoor market, and just as the downpour becomes biblical, Benidorm's very own force of nature arrives.
Oh my God, this weather, it's terrible, complete change.
Meet Vicky Caton, one of Benidorm's busiest businesswomen. Vicky owns and manages Hepburn's Hair Salon.
This is Sharon. Sharon's been with us 2 years. This is Deb. Deb's been with us 7 years. It just feels like longer. This is Oleg, our latest recruit, who has been with us this week. How are you enjoying it? How's it going?
I quite like it, yeah.
You quite like it? He loves us really, don't
you?
Yes. Yeah. He has to say yes. Otherwise, he won't have a job on Monday.
Hepburn's is right in the centre of the market, where Vicky's queen bee.
Hola, buenos dias. I know everybody because I'm a chatterbox, and I go walk about. Morning, all right?
I absolutely love the indoor market. It's like a great big family, so there are rows, there are spats, people fall out with each other.
Morning, Pam.
But when there is a crisis in there, everybody pulls together.
Hola, Monica, ¿cómo estás?
Vicky brings us together like a family. She's definitely one of the faces of the indoor market. Everyone loves it a bit.
Yorkshire lass Vicky has been married to Paul, a caravan technician, for 38 years.
My parents used to live in Benidorm, so we used to come across on holiday on a regular basis.
The more time that we spent here, the more we fell in love with the place and the more the whole way of life we liked. We talked about it and on a bit of a whim decided that we'd move over here 10.5 years ago and we're still here.
And buying the hairdressing business was an impulsive decision too.
One day she went down to have her hair done. She came back and she said, bought the salon. Yep, right, OK. And that's where it all started.
I went in there for my hair doing and I was saying I needed something to do because I was pretty bored. I got a phone call about half an hour after I'd left the salon from the lady who used to own it. So I met her for lunch. About another half an hour later, and bought the salon, and that was it. I didn't know anything whatsoever about hairdressing, nothing whatsoever remotely connected with beauty or anything like that. So I just did it in a moment's madness, maybe? I don't know. I don't regret it, but it was crazy, really. Absolutely ridiculous.
Lack of hairdressing experience hasn't stopped Vicky from turning the salon into a great success. But today, she's got other things on her mind. She's organising an MS charity event tomorrow and she's trying to get the whole market to take part.
Benidorm is like a little Britain. There are massive numbers of Brits who help and support each other. The goal is to raise €2,000 and we will do it. By hook or crook, it will be that. Would you mind having a collection tin for the World MS Day tomorrow? Excuse me 1 minute. Ah!
We have our first donation for our charity. Is this for tomorrow?
I'm away home in the morning.
You're away? Oh, darling, thank you. Do you know, the British are so generous at giving for charity. A man's just given me 10 euros. Yeah, isn't that incredible?
Oh, brilliant.
Yeah? So we're starting already.
Benidorm is home to the four S's. Sun, sea, sand, and scooters.
Scooters, the bane of Benidorm. They're an absolute pest.
Scooters are taking over the streets.
As long as you can get all your friends on one scooter, you're fine. Cheap as chips.
They've given some pensioners a whole new lease of life. And when every penny of your pension counts, they're cheap to run, too.
My mobility scooter, the actual electricity to keep it recharged, is 10 pence a week.
So you've got my initials on the front.
But for many Brits...
This is clever.
They're just an annoyance.
Little kids. They think it's wonderful. It's terrible. It's against the law, but there's no police about.
21-year-old qualified mechanic Ben Rigby from Preston is never far from a mobility scooter. But that's because he runs a scooter business with his friend Charles.
Benidorm's number one for mobility scooters in the world, and Las Vegas comes second in line with that.
Ben moved out here 2.5 years ago.
I ended up coming out here for a 2-week holiday, and then I seen how people lived. I thought, well, why can't I do it? Cheaper to live, get the sunshine every day. What more can you ask for?
Their scooter company is the only one in town flying the British flag.
We are the only English-owned company in Benidorm.
Give you a test around how to work the scooter, yeah? That's your power. This is your speed.
Customers like the fact that we can talk to them, we can have a laugh with them, and we give them whatever they need. We can understand every word that they say to us. Nice to meet you, and you have a good time while you're out.
But there's stiff competition. In fact, there's a bit of an international scooter war going on in the town. The Spanish-owned Secure Mobile are almost never closed.
We work 7 days a week.
And the biggest scooter company in Benidorm, the Dutch-owned Easy Hire, have initiated a price war.
We want to be the cheapest and the best.
The golden rule is we guarantee that we can always beat the competitor by 10 euros per week. So we always have the best rate.
However, Ben and Charles have a secret weapon. They found a cheap supplier of second-hand scooters in the UK, and it could be the golden ticket.
To buy a mobility scooter brand new, you're talking about two and a half thousand. But second-hand, we're getting for £150 in England, so it's all profit. You get years of rental out of them, and then you can sell them on for over double the profit anyway.
With cut-price scooters coming in from the UK, Ben's business is doing well, but the same can't be said for his private life. He's just split up from his girlfriend of 3.5 years, and he's feeling fragile.
Oh, you miss your family, your friends that you grew up with and that. It's hard to live out here.
It's 8:30 a.m. in Benidorm, and at the indoor market, hairdressing business owner Vicky Caton is gearing up for a charity fundraising day. She's trying to raise 2,000 euros for World MS Day, but things aren't going quite to plan.
Ah!
Stop everything. It's time for a trim.
Because it's what we do, my hair has to look reasonable. So 3 minutes, that's all I can allow myself. Although it really isn't important and I'm starting to panic. Sharon! Don't wet all my hair. I've got 3 minutes. 3 minutes. I can't be being the diva. This is about...
You're being a diva now.
No, I'm not. Well, I don't mean to be.
Money. Money.
Last year, the event raised over £1,000, but Vicky's hoping to smash that this year.
And hopefully by the end of the day, these buckets will be full. Of money, 2,000 euros to raise. We're asking a lot, but we shall go for it. You have to have a name. If you don't have a name, you don't achieve.
Elaine Charnock, who runs a money exchange bureau in the market, is helping to run the event.
The charity event started 3 years ago when my daughter was diagnosed with MS. She was 28 when she was first diagnosed. The day is not specifically just organised for my daughter. It is done for all MS sufferers.
But there's a problem. Ricky the PA man's having a bit of a mare.
Just went quiet. The speaker just went quiet for some reason. I set it all up in my garden the other day and it was perfect. Absolutely perfect. It just shows you things crop up.
Sound issue is quite a worry, but I've great faith that Ricky will fix it. He's really good and very experienced at this, and so hopefully, everything crossed, it'll be fixed very soon. Please, God, because if we've no sound, we've no show.
It's time to put the parasols up. Or maybe not.
I'm panicking now, but we're 5 minutes away from action now. Have we got raffle tickets?
Raffle tickets.
Tins, pens. Tins. Brilliant, brilliant.
It looks like Ricky's fixed the sound problem.
We're all sorted now. We're playing some background music and we're very happy, man, because I was sweating earlier.
The event kicks off, unfortunately, to a less than packed house.
Multiple sclerosis day.
But within minutes, there's an issue. A stall holder starts to complain about access to the market being blocked.
You can walk there, you can walk there, you can walk there, you can walk there.
But then things get even more serious.
The police have turned up because they need to check that we have a licence to do this. Hasta las cuatro hoy de lads. I suspect somebody has complained because we're having fun.
The charity event might have to stop before it's barely started. The British abroad love their home comforts.
So we're fat and we like the big meals.
And what warm reminder of the UK do lots of Brits crave after turning into a lobster in 30-degree heat and a few thebethers? A spicy curry, of course. Say again. 39-year-old Rajneesh Kausar left London and came to Benidorm in 2012, where he opened the clay oven, where customers head for taste bud tickling tandoori.
Beautiful, man.
I'm so glad you enjoyed it.
Hasta la vista.
Hasta la vista. Sí. Really proud of this place and really good experiences here. The only thing missing here in this restaurant is space.
The clay oven has been such a success that Raj has decided to expand, but he doesn't have far to travel to get to his new site. It's just 50 metres down the street.
Come on, I'll show you what we're doing around.
Raj is swapping his Baltis for bolognese and his poppadoms for penne, because his new venture will be an Italian restaurant.
It looks like a construction site, but I hope within the next 10 days you'll be in a restaurant.
It's a very different cuisine to curry, but Raj thinks he's a pasta master.
I opened my first restaurant business in 2004, and that was Italian. If your product is right, I think you can't go wrong in Benidorm because it's such a big market here.
On paper, it was as easy as uno, due, tre. But Raj hadn't factored in the vagaries of the Spanish building trade. It's peak season and it's still a building site. Raj is under real financial pressure.
I'd already started paying the rents here. Every day I'm losing money. We're already in the middle of the summer. Once the summer is gone, it's gone. Then we enter next year. So every day is really important. Every time I think, oh, next time I'll prepare better myself. But this is what happens every time. At the end, you start getting panic. You want to do everything quick as you can, and things start getting mixed up.
Raj wants to open in a fortnight, but that's going to be a tough deadline.
I'll keep pushing it. If I don't, if I tell myself I can't open it in 2 weeks, I will never be able to open it in 2 weeks. So I really need to push myself as well.
But there's another problem, a sizable one.
In the clay oven, we didn't have enough space, and I was crying for the terrace, which I didn't got. So whatever I was looking for next time, it should have a terrace. This time you got a terrace, and this is too big. It's nearly 35 meters. It is massive, and I hope this is really going to work out good for me.
It's a race against the clock for Raj. Will the two-week time period be enough, or could the terrace prove to be a terrible mistake? Across town, at his mobility scooter hire shop, 21-year-old Ben Rigby is paying the price for a big night on the town.
I don't want to know how I feel right now. I need to go home. Oh, I was out till about 4 or 5 o'clock in the morning last night. Too late. I'm still feeling the effects of last night, I think. Rough as a dog.
He started partying hard after a breakup with his long-term girlfriend.
It's just too easy when you finish work to just have a quick drink, and then obviously, as you know, one leads to another. It's always more than one when you're out for one drink.
The split has left Ben feeling a bit lonely.
You miss your family.
But someone's come to cheer him up. 58-year-old dad Mick has come out to stay with Ben at his caravan on Camping Villasol, and he's hoping for some quality dad and lad time.
Son's lived here for 2.5 years now, so he's having a bit of problems with his girlfriend at the moment, so I've come over to look after him.
When my dad arrived, I was in quite a bad place. He came as a surprise. My friend told me that we was going to the airport to pick a customer up, and it ended up being my dad. I was in a dark place, really, and that's why my friend got my dad brought out and to help me out, just to have somebody there for me.
Mick's on a rescue mission.
Right, see you in a bit.
But he can't do it on an empty stomach.
Just going for some breakfast.
Mick used to be a driver for Royal Mail, but chronic back problems meant he's had to take early retirement. And he's a big fan of mobility scooters.
I've had 4 titanium screws in my spine. You know, I have to use an electric scooter to get me around. But at least I get around.
He's a big fan of budget brekkies too.
You can't complain for €2.50 for a full English breakfast. Not even £2, is it, really? Probably cost them more to make it.
Well, that's not the best deal in town.
The cheapest English breakfast is €3 for a full English breakfast and a pint. Now that, what you call an English breakfast, Spanish style. Now this will fill the void for a while. Bon appetit.
Everyone needs their family around them when things get tough. And one expat in particular has the biggest extended family in Benidorm. 82-year-old Grace Campbell lives on the Arena Blanca campsite. She's adored by one and all.
People look after her, people take care of her and wonder where she is. And in the UK, that doesn't happen now.
But Grace isn't shy in retiring. In fact, she's an outrageous octogenarian. And if there was a prize for the most infectious laugh in Benidorm, there would be only one winner. Grace pays £220 a month rent at the campsite.
Caravan life is the best.
This is my patio. It is lovely here. This is my kitchen. I think that's a clock. I like that one. I love cooking with wine. Sometimes I put it in the food. This is my sitting room. That's me when I was young. Would you have fancied me?
Grace lost her husband, Mike, 18 years ago.
Actually, it's my anniversary today. 60 years, and he's not with me. We were married 42 years, and I've been on my own for 18. I could do with him round here to do some jobs.
Grace hasn't let her widowhood or old age stop her from having fun, and she has a simple motto in life.
Live, laugh and love.
And she certainly does a lot of laughing.
Whippy!
Whether she's playing pool with her mate Tommy.
You can't do that!
Or having fun with her fellow campers. Grace is a live wire.
Everybody has fun when Grace is here.
And she epitomises what Benidorm has given to lots of expats, a new lease of life.
Our philosophy, when you get to our age, yesterday's gone, tomorrow you don't know whether it's going to come, you live for today.
What have you got to do at home? You're an old lady, they call you. You can stay there and do that. And... No, no, no. We still want to live. enjoy life more.
Grace benefits greatly from being here, without a doubt. It wouldn't be the same for her in the UK. You know, she'd wither away. She is the life and soul of any party.
There's only one way to describe Grace. She is amazing Grace.
At the Indoor Market Charity Day, the party is now in full swing.
Thank you.
Satisfied that the event has the correct permit, the police have moved on. The crowd are finding their feet, but Vicky wants them to find their wallets.
A euro and strip, tombola. I'm going to be hoarse in a minute.
But she's not happy.
There are lots of people here, but I don't think we're taking the money at the minute. Everybody's having a great time, yes, but we need the money. That's what it's all about. So I need to go out there now, sell some raffle tickets and try and get some more cash in. Raffle tickets, a euro and strip. Raffle tickets, a euro and strip.
Also trying to drum up donations is co-organiser Elaine. And her daughter Carly's arrived to join in the fun.
I've been diagnosed with MS for about 3 years now, so we decided to do the event to be able to raise money for treatment and for a better life for people with the illness.
It looks like a good time's being had by all.
It's going very well, people are having a great time, but I'm still very concerned about how much money we're actually raising. And it's disappointing when it is for a good cause. Thank you so,
so much.
Thank you.
I'm going to say bye-bye to you all. Thank you very much, and I'd like a big thank you for all the entertainers, all the staff. We have a big round of applause.
I'm tired, but happy, but we just could have done with more people being here today. We're going to go and count the money, and that's the moment of truth.
At Benidorm's indoor markets, the MS Charity Day has drawn to a close. The crowds have drifted away and the moment of truth has arrived. It's time to count the money.
It looks better than I thought.
Yeah, I reckon there's more notes than...
I think there might be more notes than last year.
We've got 20 in the first hand that we've opened, so we see some really generous people.
Yay, that's a good 10. That's a good 10.
Event organiser, hairdressing business owner Vicky Caton is hoping to raise more than €2,000. It looks promising, but have they reached their target?
We raised 1,100, which we were disappointed with because we wanted more, but you have to aim high, don't you? You have to aim for something. You can't be satisfied. You always need more. So next year it will be better.
Vicky lives in Lanuthia, 8 kilometres from the centre of Benidorm, with her husband Paul and their 4 dogs.
I've lived here for 10.5 years now, but we've had the house for 11.5. We bought it as a holiday home, and then when we moved here, decided we might as well live in it. What I like about it is it's nice and open and airy. And then we have our little garden, which is not really big enough now. We have 4 dogs.
The couple's lives in Benidorm are very different to the lives they left behind in the UK.
I started my life as a trainee tax assistant, working for an accountant, helping clients to save money. I did tax for a lot of years.
And Paul was the MD of his own business, a transport company. But he realised he had to find a different career if he moved to Spain.
Once we'd made the decision to move, I came across business in caravans, as a caravan technician. And I thought, yeah, that's what I'm going to do.
There was just one tiny problem.
I'd never worked with caravans ever. What I knew, I could probably tell you in 5 minutes. What I didn't know would take me all year. I then went back to England, went to ask a local caravan company for a job. Just train me. Not interested in being paid, just train me. And I worked there, learning everything I could about motorhomes, caravans, the water systems, the heating systems, anything that could possibly go wrong. I was the apprentice, you know. People were telling me what to do. I had to accept that. And I was prepared to do it because I wanted to learn. And I'm so pleased that I did it.
Paul's inside caravans every working day and is continuously impressed by the ingenuity of his British clients.
You could walk into an awning on a caravan site in Benidorm and literally believe you were in a house. You could even have walls plastered, tile floors. You got your three-piece suite, your fridge, your dining table, your TV, everything you'd want to make comfortable living. Some of the kitchens I've seen are better than in my house.
There are just 7 days to go until owner Raj Kauser opens his new Italian restaurant. A week ago, the place was a building site. Today, it's still a building site.
This is my storage area. Bit messy at the moment.
That's something of an understatement, but there are a few signs of improvement.
At least here we are nearly done with everything. That's done. I've got all my plants. Lamp posts are there. I really like them, I don't know why. I didn't want it to have this wall really blank and boring. I think that gives the idea of pastas in Italians. I hope it will make some appetite.
Raj definitely has a glass half-full outlook on life.
I've already got my beer connected. We are done with the menus, so it's pretty much there. And it really feels good when people pass by and ask you, oh, it really looks nice when you're going to open it. Let's see how it goes. I'm quite excited now.
Raj has sunk £140,000 into the place, and the building work has overrun massively. But at least it's finally beginning to look like a restaurant.
I was a bit worried earlier because, I mean, things were not going the way I wanted them to. I always calculated on my summer period, and the summer was just slipping away from my hands. But now, as you can see, it's looking good. I'm quite confident it's going to be good.
The restaurant will open in 7 days' time, but if the place isn't finished, the opening night could be a disaster.
Opening is always challenging. There's always something missing. You can never be perfect.
At Camping Villasol, 21-year-old Ben Rigby and his dad Mick are being picked up for a day of fishing with the boys.
We're off on my road trip.
Mobility scooter boss Charles is on driving duty.
I put my seatbelt on, not for safety reasons, for his driving reasons.
Mick's got a plan to make a few quid from the trip.
If you catch bass, get to the nearest restaurant and see if they want to buy them. Ask them how much they'll give you for them. Because they're fresh and caught, they'll take them off you.
The lads are driving to Masquerat, 10 kilometres north of Benidorm, and Mick's hoping a change of scenery will help take Ben's mind off his failed romance.
Half the time, I can't wait to get out of Benidorm. I've spent my time there, I've drunk there every night, I've probably been in every bar, so it just gets boring after a while, and it's just not the life you want to lead, really.
This is where we're going to be fishing, right here on the rocks here.
Yo, let's get fishing.
Benidorm breakfast. Kebab.
It's a cheap day trip for the boys.
Yeah, a lot of people do come out for excursions. It costs them quite a bit of money. It costs us nothing. Just a few cans from the supermarket. And that's it. And a bit of bait.
There's a pretty big fish in town already today.
Is that Abramovich? Is that one? Mr. Moneybags, who owns Chelsea. That's his boat there.
That is one boat, that.
Or to have money, eh?
The guys get their tackle out in no time, and the fishing begins.
See what we've got?
Nook. Not too bad.
Not too bad for a beginner.
But Ben's still got his ex on his mind.
Oh, it's just been mental. I've been drinking for 3 weeks solid. She was my first love, like, we was together for 3.5 years. But you get over it. Plenty more fish in sea. We'll catch one now. That's it, get out there. Catch me some fish.
Seeing Ben desperately unhappy has been hard for Mick too.
I'll give you every bit of advice I can give you. If you don't take it, you don't take it. But hopefully he's learnt his lesson.
So I just need to drink in and knock on head. I don't know, it's time to get my head down.
And he's not a drinker. It does not suit him whatsoever. So that's it, he's grounded from drinking now. Yeah, he's already grounded.
Fishing trip helped me a lot because it gave me some chance to spend quality time with my dad rather than just going out and getting drunk.
It's been great father and son time, but the fishing skills need working on. No one's landed a thing all day.
That's why we're not catching any fish, it's your fault.
Oh, it's all these bloody jet skis and boats, isn't it? Excuse me, will you tell them people to stop enjoying themselves?
Back in town, it's a busy Saturday morning at Hepburn's, but the boss isn't there. This being Benidorm, where nothing's straightforward, she's got another job.
Here's more of the music you love with Vicky Caton.
This is Clive.
from Spain.
Well, good morning, Costa Blanca. Your weather today in the Benidorm area is absolutely fabulous. Highs 27 degrees, lows tonight 14.
Vicky's gone from pampering to presenting. She's a DJ at one of the fastest-growing radio stations on the Costa Blanca, Cool FM.
Coming up now, we've got another request going out to my bestie, Andrea and Simon.
All the presenters are volunteer British expats, and Vicky has her own Saturday show.
It's a great fun job. I absolutely love it. I can play anything I like on a Saturday morning. It's beautiful, absolutely fantastic. I love it, love it, love it. Best morning of the week. Have a great weekend, guys. I'll see you very soon.
Across town, after massive delays that have put enormous financial pressure on its owner, Raj Kausair, the finishing touches are being done, the kitchen staff are prepping, and the Italian garden restaurant's almost ready, which is a good thing as it opens in 5 minutes. The menu's attracting some interest, and the first reactions are positive.
I think this restaurant will do very well because it's going to give a nice variety to the food selection around here. I think it'll take off.
Owner Raj is a little stressed. He's so keen to open and get the tills ringing, he hasn't fully briefed his staff.
Everything happened so quickly. I mean, we didn't have enough time so that we can have a little meeting together. We could have discussed things. We didn't even discuss table numbers.
But there's no time for that now because his first customers have already arrived.
It was a bit more of a shock, really, wasn't it? Yeah. Realised we was the first customers. You've got to try something new every time, haven't you?
It's half of the relief that I've got customer. I'll get the other half once they get satisfied. So challenge is still there.
Raj's friend, expat John Kelly, has turned up to show some support.
An Indian opening an Italian restaurant, taking a lot of balls.
Fair play to him.
Opening night's stressful for anybody, especially when it's a brand new venture and there's hardly any decent Italians in Benidorm. And he's going to make a go of it. I think so.
The first plates to leave the kitchen are served. And the first reviews are not far behind.
Very tasty, yes.
I ordered spicy, but it's not really spicy.
Spice Girl's not happy, but her colleagues are.
Because we were the first customers, they gave us the drinks for free. If we were here for another week, we'd be back again, definitely. It's lovely. Really, really nice.
So far, so good.
The early nerves settle. The kitchen gets into gear and the punters start to roll in.
Any more drinks order?
And the decor gets the thumbs up.
I think they've done a beautiful job. Amazing job. Yeah. I love that.
Yeah. I'm found with the fountain.
So far, it's a fantastic start. I was really under pressure the whole day, but now things are settling down, so I'm really happy about everything.
Prizing cash out of Brits' mitts isn't an easy ask. And watching the pennies more than most are 60-year-old twins, Catherine and Patricia from Warrington. They bought a caravan together on Camping Villamar 12 months ago. And they love one thing more than anything, spending as little money as possible.
I have a diary and I write how much I've spent. And by the end of the week, sometimes, I might have only spent 20 euros. In this week, all I spent was 37 euros. I think when people have been here for a while, they say, right, we're living here now, we really need to tidy our belts. You know, in this one, I spent €1 on the aqua lesson.
Kath and Pat are Benidorm super savers, and they patrol the areas where the bins are kept, looking for items people have thrown away. And their favourite spot is the wall next to the shower block, which even has its own nickname.
Patricia and I call it Walmart because you can go and you can pick up virtually anything for free.
See, someone's put those on there, they're Walmart. If you want to have these shoes, you take them. Somebody doesn't want them, and they're not old. We got these from Walmart. These from Walmart. That's from Walmart. One chest of drawers we got from Walmart.
The twins tour Villamar every day without fail.
There are always people buying caravans, leaving caravans, wanting to get rid of things. And so if I see anything, I'll pick it up and I'll recycle it myself. Just
think.
Is there any chips in it?
No.
They always say, don't they, one person's trash is another person's treasure. And there's nothing like getting a buzz from something that you really want to treasure and somebody's throwing it out because it's their trash. So it's great, isn't it?
Yes. Yes.
We love it.
Benidorm might be in Spain, but at times it feels like a British enclave. And when it comes to Spanish language and food, generally speaking, us Brits aren't brilliant.
I'd like to learn Spanish, but it's actually sitting and learning it that I couldn't be bothered with.
Some British people try to speak Spanish, but most of them only know three words: hola, cerveza, beer, adios.
One cerveza, one beer, vino, blanco, white wine. So I've got the basics.
Si cerveza, por favor.
I'm not really into a lot of Spanish food. That's how I'm back into Spain, like English food.
Say Sprite in Spanish, which is just basically the same, but with a Spanish accent. And I could say un momento.
British people don't speak Spanish, just speak English.
Café con leche.
No, that's not Spanish, though, is it?
Is that Spanish?
Oh, I can say that as well.
That's Spanish.
Well, that was Italian.
Donde es el lavabo? That means where is the sink? You always need to know where a sink is.
I was going to go do Spanish lessons, but there's no point because everybody speaks English.
Hola, ¿cómo estás? Estamos en Benidorm haciendo una fiesta.
Because everybody speaks English, we just don't have to bother.
One person who is embracing the Spanish way of life is charity organiser, DJ and boss of Hepburn's hair salon, Vicky Caton. Today she's hatched a plan to bring a bit of Spain into the salon. Any excuse to pop some corks.
Whee! Boom!
Oh, expertly done, darling. Today is going to be our Spanish day, so we're going to be giving everybody a little bit of tapa and some cava or vino tinto or sangria.
Although she isn't yet fluent, Vicky's tried hard to learn the lingo.
Sí, OK, vale, vale. Hablamos en español. Todo el día, chicas.
We have chosen to live in somebody else's country, and I think it's hugely important that we make an effort to learn as much languages as possible. And the number of British people I know who've lived here 20 years who speak no Spanish at all and have no Spanish friends is incredible.
But today, it's ole all the way. The carver's flowing,
cheers.
The sangria's sorted, and the tapas is tempting the punters.
You don't just want egg and chips all the time, yeah. Of course you want to eat Spanish as well. I've already had an English breakfast this morning, so I'm doing both.
But not everyone's as keen to try.
Just don't look very inviting, do
you? Come on, be brave. Tracy's lived here 7 years. She has never had tapas all the time she's lived here.
Oh, that's nice. That's nice,
sir. Oh, they're lovely, those. So what do you think to your first tapas experience, then?
Yeah, it's very nice.
So you'll do it again?
I will try it again.
Tracy's getting a taste for the tapas and Vicky's getting a taste for the sangria.
It's a shame I'm driving today, actually. I might have to abandon my car.
Time to get the market a little merry.
¿Quieres tomar sangria?
Sí.
Sí? Vale?
Vale.
Sangria, sangria? My mum-in-law. I might know she'd arrive as soon as she'd smell sangria.
Oh, yeah,
it makes work fun, doesn't it? We are in a service industry and it's nice to do something different and make everybody happy and put a smile on people's faces. I'm trying to say our Spanish day was very successful.
Nuestro día dedicado a España ha sido todo un éxito.
Nuestro día de España ha sido...
todo un éxito.
Todo un éxito.
After a month in Benidorm, Mick Clarkson's flying back to the UK.
Last lot packed, ready for the airport.
This is the last brew I've met you for a while, Daddy.
When Mick arrived, his son Ben was down in the dumps after a breakup with his girlfriend.
Don't want to know how I feel right now. Rough as a dog.
But Mick sorted him out.
I've done my job, mission completed. And it seemed like mission impossible at start. Take it from me, Dad. I don't think he's going to go backwards now. Forwards and onwards.
The pair now set off to the airport.
When we get back home to raining Manchester.
Ben's hired a van for a few days, but he's dropped a bit of a clanger.
I don't believe it. No way.
Don't say you've locked keys in the van.
Yeah.
You've locked the keys in the van?
You are kidding me.
Well, that's great, that. Ben, how am I going to get to the airport? This is all we need now, Ben.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, that was lucky.
Look at that.
That was lucky.
Now, that's what you call a window of opportunity.
Well, goodbye, Villasol. Hope to see you again soon. You take care. Bye. Don't forget to bring me. Keep in touch with me, all right? Drive easy, Ben, on the way back.
I was sad to see my dad go, because he definitely helped me a lot when I was in that bad place. My head was literally only just getting around what was going on.
Airport is always the worst part.
It was bad to see him go, filled up a bit, but I'm a big boy, I can cope with it.
I think he's got peace of mind for going home now. As much as he does hate leaving, I think he knows he's done his job.
Mick may have departed, but Ben's back on track and refocused at work. He's given up the boozy nights, but he's still not got his eye completely on the job, because he's got a new girlfriend.
I have met a girl called Courtney, yeah.
Hola, guapa.
What?
She's a lovely girl. She's the best girl I could ask for, really. Life's a lot better now. Definitely happy now.
Next time on Bargain Loving Brits in the Sun, an expat entrepreneur falls foul of Spanish bureaucracy.
We're not doing anything illegal, we're just trying to earn an honest living.
And a special offer at a local bar pulls him in.
I'm laid naked on my bar.
Come on, Paul, look like you're enjoying it.